As an employer, you should always comply with EEOC's requests and permit their on-site visitation and interviewing of their employees. Hi, my name is Yuri Han. I'm a junior associate attorney here at Sully Law. My main duties include contract review, drafting contracts like commercial, real estate, transaction, bylaws of the companies, and I also do a little bit of pre-litigation matters. EEOC stands for Equal Employment Opportunity Commission. It is a federal agency that enforces federal anti-discrimination laws. It is illegal for companies to discriminate against a person based on person's age, 40 years and older, gender, including pregnancy, sexual orientation, and gender identity, national origin, religion, race, and color. Receiving a notice from EEOC does not mean that the company has violated federal anti-discrimination law. It simply states that the EEOC has received a charge of complaint. EEOC will investigate the matter. In general, a person must file a complaint within 180 days of alleged violation. The deadline is extended to 300 days if a complaint is also covered by state anti-discrimination law. It may mean an employee losing his right to bring a lawsuit in federal or state court related to federal anti-discrimination law. So even if you believe the charge is entirely baseless, you should still carefully read the charge, conduct an internal investigation to gather all relevant documents and witness statements. Employer must have a sufficient number of employees to be considered a covered employer. For example, the Americans with Disabilities Act is enforced by EEOC against an employer that has 15 or more employees for each working day in each of 20 or more calendar weeks in the current or preceding calendar year. An employer may submit their quarterly wage report for EEOC to determine if it should be considered a covered employer. If parties agree to mediate, the EEOC will assign a mediator for both parties. Mediation is completely voluntary and confidential. If either party decides not to participate in mediation, you as an employer must submit your position statement. If warranted, an employer should also include a non-discriminatory reason for its actions. For example, the company may indicate the person was fired not because of alleged discriminatory violation, but because of person's poor work performance or failure to abide by company policy. The major advantage of mediation is that both parties can reach an early settlement by actively engaging in negotiation and exchanging counteroffers through a neutral mediator. By settling the matter early on, your company is able to focus on growing your business and avoid lengthy investigation and lawsuit. As an employer, you should always comply with EEOC's requests and permit their on-site visitation and interviewing of their employees. First of all, it does not happen in court, and nowadays mediation can be even conducted virtually. Companies should indicate what is considered discrimination and harassment, and state companies' commitment to anti-discrimination law. An employer should have an internal process for submitting confidential discrimination and harassment complaint. Once a complaint is received, a company should conduct a prompt and impartial investigation and take appropriate corrective and remedial measures. An employer should keep detailed file for each employee and document employee's performance and communication and behavior issues, and maintain such documents even after employee depart for at least a couple of years. Make sure your recruitment agency abide by anti-discrimination law. You should ensure your company policies are well communicated to your employees and be accessible at all times to your employees. You should document everything, positive and negative. In keeping reports, always include the name, dates, every detail of the event while it's fresh in your mind. If you receive any notice of charge from EEOC, please consult your local counsel. We're always here to help.